The body metal I used to repair the box. This is the car it come out of. And you can tell by looking at it that the only thing on it that's any good was the roof, which I cut out the body metal to fix my box. And goddamn mosquitoes are gonna eat me alive up here too. And you can see the car not exactly out in the open. It's in the woods. And believe it or not, this used to be a highway. It was, and then they put in the current highway, which you can hear out there. And this was deeded over to the original owner of the property. Yeah, place to put vehicles to work on them anyway, still got to deal with weather, but hell, at least it's solid ground. Better than gravel. In my estimation, anyway. So here we have a redneck window fan. Anybody who knows cars, obviously you can see that that's actually a cooling fan out of a car. But it moves the air around, it works pretty good. PS2's also been redneck because it had a habit of overheating, so I added a fan to it. All that is, just a put a power cord on it and run it off of a computer power supply, off the 12 volt output. Go on out of there, fool. Go on. Get away from the goddamn window. There's no screen. That's Max. Get. Quit being a dink. Go away. Go find a window that's got a screen in it. Dummy. Redneck window fan. Said. It's actually a fan out of a computer power supply, hooked up to the computer power supply, cool off the PS2. Not the only thing I've redneck around here though. My speaker that doubles as a computer desk, and a beer holder, and a place to charge my cell phone. So on and so forth. I would love to have the money to have one of those cars. Someday if I'm ever rich, I'll have one of those cars. The old classic Z28. If I had that kind of money, I wouldn't be rebuilding a fucking old Ranger, that's for sure. Okay, so there's my redneck speaker that doubles as a desk in my cluttered mess of a living room. My other homemade speaker that doubles as a printer stand. Run off the 35-year-old radio. Oh, what else? Oh, yeah, my shelf. It used to be a dresser drawer. Clothesline, inside, underwear. And that's somewhere to put it, right? What else have I read around here? Yeah, there's my speaker, my fan, another speaker. Let me see. Then my daughter's disaster of a bedroom. Where I also keep some of my toolboxes because the apartment's so damn small. There's a homemade bicycle I builder out of a 25-year-old bike frame. Extended the swing arm, added a chain guard, a sprocket, different front end. Hi, Fluffy. Yes, I see you. Hi. Oh yeah, I see you too, Max. I'm showing off the clutter around here to people out there. Don't be concerned, they're not going to blame the clutter on you. Thinking of it, I'm not going to be working on the Ranger for a couple of weeks. I might have time to clean this fucking mess up. Empties. Let's see. Oh yes, Redneck ventilation. We have a fan in the window here. Better check my fries. Yeah, got some time yet. Fan in the window out here. Tiny little apartment. Fan in the window out here. Both blowing in. And the fart fan sucking out. I don't know if you call that redneck in ventilation or just small apartment intuition. Intuition, no. That's not it. What the hell's the word I'm looking for? Somebody tell me the word I'm looking for. Initiative, that's it. Pick up these pillows that mysteriously landed on the armchair. Although I don't know who put them there. Couldn't have been me. Must have been the other person that's here while I'm here by myself. Oh yes. The vacuum handle held together with electrical tape. The fan vent is a shirt I wear wearing on the truck. Working on the truck. Yeah, I guess that would be classified as a redneck clothes dryer. Fan there to move air to dry the clothes quicker. But you make do with what you can get your hands on when you haven't got a whole lot of cash. And I haven't got a whole lot of cash.